Okay, take two, because I did it and I forgot to save it because I haven't made a video in how long, right? So I have been MIA and it's not intentional. It is panic. I'm in panic mode. So Julian went away to camp. I'm full of anxiety. Julian went away to Boy Scout camp for a week and I kind of lost my purpose and I felt depressed. I felt awful. I felt awful because I suddenly had no one to focus on because, God forbid, I focus on myself. I preach it to everyone. Focus on yourself. Focus on yourself. And then when it was my time, I was like, ugh. So I have to get back to school. I have to get back to work. I've been on disability since 2016. For medical reasons, I had to medically retire from my job, just in case you didn't see any other videos of mine. I am doing fitness journeys, and you can see that this is all still here because everything stopped because of all this anxiety. I'm trying to brand my Manifesting Motherhood. I had a blog. I lost the blog. It told me my blog did not exist. Me and Julian were out, and all of a sudden I see the old phone that of mine that he uses, and I see an icon for the blog, and I'm like, oh, shit. So I go on there. Get it back, and now I have to make blog posts. And that's giving me anxiety. Not making these videos and being consistent, giving me anxiety. Not being able to enroll in school because I'm disabled and I don't qualify for a personal student loan because I'm disabled without a real income, so maybe they should pay disabled people a real fucking income or have a way for us to find a different career to get off fucking disability. Anyway, I digress. This has been a whirlwind for me, and I have been high and low, depressed and anxious, happy. I started these beautiful groups out in the garden of moon ceremonies, full moon, new moon, cutting the cord. I'm going to be starting Reiki circles out there, and I don't get, there's no payment or anything, but I'm meeting a group of people that are like-minded like me, and sometimes the energy is overwhelming for me, and I welcome it. I'm open to it. I'm not closing myself off. And actually, next Thursday is the new moon, and we were going to have a ceremony, but we're celebrating my niece's birthday, so I'm not doing it. Anyway, the consistency of, okay, Ollie, not now. The consistency of what I want to do and what I'm actually doing is failing. And I'm always telling people, no matter what, time will pass, whether you're doing what you wanted to do or not. If you're sitting on your ass doing nothing, either way, the time is going to pass. So I start school in a couple days because I was able, between garage sales and borrowing money and whatever, get ready for my first 10 weeks of school because I'm doing online class. Because I can't afford the school that I wanted to go to, and they have no kind of programs or scholarships or grants or anything. Grants that I filled out online, either I'm not amputated enough, I didn't have enough amputated, or I'm not disabled enough, or I'm not sick enough, or I'm not single mother enough, and it's fucking frustrating. It's so frustrating. And the ones that I do qualify for, there's probably tens of thousands of people. So I didn't get them, and I am at my wit's end because I want this so bad, and I feel like I'm in a cycle of fuck you. So I'm selling anything I have because I realize that I need to declutter my mental, my physical, my emotional, and I'm doing that. So I think about it in my room, in my house. If I were to die or if I were to move, what would I keep or what would they keep and what would get thrown out? And anything that I wouldn't pack to go to my next home is going. I'm going to have another garage sale, hopefully make, you know, a couple hundred dollars, and that can go towards my next 10 months of school because I don't know what else to do. And if you're someone that's out there that is really wealthy and you want to pay for me to go to school, okay. Or if you're someone that knows of a program that can help me, okay, I'm down. If you're someone that wants to send me $5 to help me, I'm good. I'm not soliciting money. I'm just saying. Because I don't know what else to fucking do. Anyway, thanks for being on my journey with me. It internally and externally sucks sometimes, but I appreciate where I am. I have gratitude for what I have. I appreciate those in my life that ride with me, that lift me up, that are here through no matter what, because they love me and they know that it's reciprocated. Grateful for my baby boy who started school, decided he doesn't want to do after school soccer, and I said, fuck that. Because I'm not letting him quit. If someone would have said, you can't move out in 12th grade, I wouldn't have. If someone said, you have to stick with this, I would have. And I'm not going to allow him to keep dropping shit because it's a long day. Because in life, we have long fucking days. And it's only till November, the soccer team. So 2 months, you can do it. You can do it, doodle. And that's it. Okay, I have so much more and I just can't. I'm going to go do some breathing. My room is a fucking, it's a wreck and a half. I'm living in like, but I'm going to sort through it today, tomorrow, Saturday, Sunday. I'm doing Reiki Masters teaching, and peace out, Girl Scouts.